Choreb Beruach,
Sword of the Spirit. Interpreted and narrated by Wendy. BeRashit, Genesis, Chapter 49.
And Joqub called to his sons and said, "Gather yourselves together, that I may tell you that which will befall you in the last days. Gather yourselves together and hear, you sons of Joqub, and hearken unto Yeshareel, your father. Reuben, you are my firstborn, my might, and the beginning of my strength, the excellency of dignity and power. Unstable as water, you will not excel, because you went upon your father's bed, and you defiled it. He went upon my couch. Shimaun and Lehui are brothers, instruments of violent heresies. My soul will not enter into their council. In their assembly, my honor will not be united. For in their anger they slew a man, and in their delight they crippled an ox. Cursed is their anger, for it is fierce, and their wrath, for it is cruel. I will divide them in Joqub, and scatter them in Yeshareel. Yehuda, you are he whom your brethren will praise. Your hand will be on the neck of your enemies. Your father's children will bow down before you. Yehuda is a lion's whelp. From the prey, my son, you will ascend. He will stoop down. He will lay down like a lion. Yet, as a mature lion, who will rouse him up? The scepter will not depart from Yehuda, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shilu, heavenly peace, comes. Then unto him the peoples will obey. Bind the filly to a vine, and the colt of his jenny to a choice vine. Wash his garment in wine, and her veil in the blood of grapes. The darkening of eyes is from wine, but the brightening of teeth is from milk. Zebulun will dwell in the haven of the sea, and he will be a haven of ships, and his border will be towards Sidon. Yeshakar is a strong ass, crouching down between two burdens. And he saw that rest was good, and the land was pleasant. Therefore he bowed his shoulder to carry and become a servant to tribute. Dan, his people will be contested as one of the tribes of Yeshareel. Dan will be a serpent by the way, an otter in the path who bites the horse's heels, so that his rider falls backwards. O Yehua, I have waited for your salvation. God is a troop. He is our invader, and he will have fortune in the end. Out of Asher, his bread will be fat, and he will yield royal dainties. Naphtali is a doe sent forth. Will the speech be good? The fruitful descendant of Yusup is a fruitful descendant beside a spring. His daughters will march beside an ox. Yet the master of arrows will be bitter to him and shoot. Also, he will hate him. But his bow will remain strong, and the agility of his arm's hands will be from the hand of the Aber, guardian of Joqub, the shepherd, the rock of Yeshareel, by the all of your father, who will help you, and by the Almighty, who will endow you with the endowments of the heavens above, endowments of the deep that lies below, endowments of the breasts and womb. The endowments of your father has prevailed above the endowments of my ancestors, to the utmost boundary of the hills, forever. They will be upon the head of Yusup, and upon the crown of his Nezer, consecrated one, of his brethren. Binyamin will ravage like a wolf. In the morning he will devour the prey. Then, at night, he will divide the plunder. All these are the 12 tribes of Yeshareel. And this is what their father spoke to them and endowed them. Everyone according to his endowment, he endowed them. Then he charged them and said to them, I am to be gathered unto my people. Bury me with my fathers in the cave that is in the field of Abron, the Hitti, in the cave that is in the field of Machpelah, which is before Mamre, in the land of Canaan, which Abraham bought with the field of Abron, the Hitti, for a possession of a burial place. There they buried Abraham and Sharah his wife. There they buried Jatsakhaq and Rivkah his wife. And there I buried Leah. The purchase of the field and of the cave that is in it was from the children of Chet. And when Joqub made an end of instructing his sons, he gathered up his feet into the bed and died. Thus he was gathered to his people. Therefore Yusuf fell upon his father's face. Then he wept upon him and kissed him.